Ja, hallihallo und herzlich willkommen zu Let's Show Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc. Ja, ich weiß, wir hatten das Ganze schon mal. Allerdings hatte ich da wirklich grauenhafte Audioqualität. Und ja, ich habe einen Weg gefunden, das zu fixen. Und deswegen dachte ich mir, ich nehme das Ganze hier nochmal neu auf. Weil ich diesen Part, oder besser, dieses Let's Show, einfach nicht so in der Qualität stehen lassen wollte. So, ich glaube allerdings, dass ich die alten Parts löschen werde, nicht, dass es irgendwie zu Verwirrung kommt und so. Und, ja. Erstmal dann wieder die allgemeine Vorstellung, was es glaubt, Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc. Ja, dieses Game ist für Steam, PlayStation 4 und PlayStation Vita erschienen. Zuallererst war es für PlayStation Vita, später dann halt geremaked. Und, ja. Playstyle hier, es ist eine Art Detektiv-Game. Und zwar geht es darum, dass wir hier 16 Schüler haben. Nein, 15. Fängt ja gut an. Und wir wurden alle zu einer Art Elite-Akademie eingeladen. Und wir müssen halt bestimmte Fälle auflösen. Und da gibt es natürlich immer einen Verdächtigen. Das ist so ein bisschen, ja, einmal halt Beweise suchen. Und einmal halt steht man da vor Gericht und muss den Schuldigen finden. Das kann man so ein bisschen, ja, wie die Phoenix Wright Games vergleichen, falls einem das ein Begriff ist. So, jetzt will ich auch nicht zu viel labern, also starten wir ein New Game. Englisch bitte. Ich bin nicht so gut in Japanisch. Logic Difficulty, nehmen wir mal Mean, Action auch Mean. Jetzt zeigen wir nur den Prolog in diesem Let's Show. Trigger Happy Havoc, Danganronpa. Ja, nach diesem epischen Zwischensequenz geht's auch weiter mit den offenen Textboxen. Da es ja so ein Detektiv-Game ist, ist natürlich auch selbstverständlich sehr viel Text da drin. Deswegen werde ich mich jetzt nicht allzu oft einklinken, nur halt ab und zu mal. Und ja, würde euch so ein bisschen mit Text niederriesen lassen. The massive high school towers of all the other buildings in this busting urban area. It's like the school sits at the center of the entire world. Hope's Peak Academy. It brings in top students from every field imaginable. A government-founded school of Power League. They say that if you come here and manage to graduate, you'll be set for life. With hundreds of years of tradition, it sends the cream of the crop into the work forced every year. It was built to raise hope in the nation's future, which makes Hope's Peak a pretty fitting name. There are two things you need to attend the school. 1. You have to already be attending high school. 2. You have to be the very best at what you do. No ordinary student could enroll here. The only way in is if you are scouted by the school itself, and standing there at the gate of the ultimate school, filled with the ultimate students, was me.
Before we go any farther, I guess I should introduce myself. My name's Makoto Naegi.
Einer der wenigen, ja, Sprachausgaben in diesem Game. As you can see, I'm nothing but a hopelessly average high school student. Average on the outside, average on the inside. I really don't have much going for me when it comes to grades, special abilities, even personality. I mean, yeah, I have hobbies and stuff I like to do, but it's not like I'm a psycho or a mutant or whatever. Like, if you ask me what my favorite song was, or my favorite movie or TV show, they'd all just be whatever's most popular at a particular moment. Even among the average, I'm completely average, so I can't even say I'm your everyday hero type. That's just who I am. Anyway, I figured it's always good to introduce yourself right off the bat. But you know, if I have any kind of strong point, so to speak, I'd say I'm a little more gung-ho than other people. I mean, look at me, I'm completely ordinary, but still. Here I am, standing in front of the anything but ordinary Hope's Peak Academy. I still can't believe I'm standing here. I wonder if someone like me can survive in a place like this. It's got this overwhelming presence, like it's trying to swallow me whole. But it's no wonder I would feel that way. What you have to understand is, well, let me just tell you about the preparation I did last night to get ready for today. Ja, hier sind so ein bisschen die anonymen Namen von ein paar unserer Mitschüler. Hier haben wir zum Beispiel unseren Pop Sensation Star. Dann haben wir noch der ultimative Basketballer. Ja, kann man das so ein bisschen ablesen. Hope's Peak only invites those students who are the truly elite in their field. It's such a popular topic, there are threads online dedicated to talking about the school's attendees. So to prepare, I looked up some of those threads, and all I saw was talk about ultimate students who are way beyond your average high schooler. For example, one incoming student is the ultimate pop sensation. I guess she's a high school girl who's also the lead singer for a pop group famous all over the country. There's also the ultimate baseball star. He was the cleanup hitter for the national high school. Champs, pro teams already have their eyes on him. Then there's the ultimate fashionista. She's been on the cover of tons of fashion magazines. She is what every high school girl wants to be. Junko Inoshima sehen wir hier an dieser Zeitschrift. Junko Inoshima, so ein kleiner Fun Fact, ist übrigens der meiste cosplayte Videospielcharakter bis jetzt. Oh, and they mentioned the Ultimate Baker Gang leader too. The scary thing is, he's the facto leader of every biker gang in Japan. Gangs everywhere love this guy. On top of that, there's the ultimate material artist, the ultimate fanfic creator, the ultimate gambler, the ultimate swinging pro, the ultimate programmer, the ultimate clairvoyant, was auch immer das bedeutet, And then some reading that made me realize how totally powerless I was. It was the country's thinnest top to bottom. I feel like a tame little house cat who'd wandered into a pride of lions. But still, there was something I could stop thinking about. You see, there were a few students who I couldn't find any info on, no matter how much I looked. With all those ultimate students, I'm the only one without any kind of worthwhile talent. But then, what about those other new students, who didn't seem to pop up anywhere? Could they be just average students like me, without any talent or anything? That thought was kind of encouraging. I mean, I know I don't have much in the way of personality, but beyond that, there's an even bigger issue. How did such an unbelievably average student like me get picked to come to this ultimate high school? I mean, I guess there's a reason. You just have to take one glass at acceptance letter they sent me to see why. We recently held a lottery to select one ordinary student to attend our school. As a result, you have been selected, and we invite you to join us as the ultimate lucky student. Let's spell it out plain as the day. I got invited by pure luck. Honestly, I probably would have been better off just declining their offer. But after hearing how graduating was a guarantee for success later in life, I just couldn't say no. But then, actually standing there in front of the school, I started to feel lost, like I didn't belong there. I could feel myself losing my nerve. But still, I can't just stand here in front of the gateway forever. Frozen in place, murmuring to myself, I looked down at the acceptance letter clutched in my hand. It said there'd be a meeting for all incoming students in the main hall at 8 a.m. The meeting still isn't for a little while, but I should probably just head in. Yeah, let's do this! I gave it up all my determination and tried to act like I'd done this a million times before. And I took my first step toward the main hall. This is where I'm supposed to meet, right? I guess I'm the first one here. There's a really elegant clock over in the corner. It says it's 7:10 a.m. Ich glaube, ich habe gerade voll die Zeit falsch ausgesprochen, aber egal. The meeting doesn't start until 8 o'clock, so there's still a full 50 minutes left. It makes sense nobody else would be here yet. I was so wound up, I got here way too early. We have plenty of time for the meeting, just standing around waiting isn't exactly... I should take a look around the school. Maybe that will help me calm down a little. I am a student here now, so there shouldn't be any problem with me having a look around, right? It will help me kill some time, if nothing else. Trying to play it cool, I took my first step into Hope's Peak Academy. It was also my first step toward starting a new life at a new school. At least, that's what I was hoping for. What the? But the instant I took that first step forward, my view became warped, twisted. It was like some kind of delusion, melting away and mixing together into something else. Spinning, mixing, melting away, then spinning again, and the next moment, everything went black. That was how it all began, and how life as I knew it came to an end. At that point, I should have realized the reason I was brought to Hope's Peak Academy wasn't because I had ultimate luck. It was so I could experience ultimate despair. Welcome to Despair Prologue. Do we want to save the data? Ich verzichte. What? Where am I? I walk off with my head resting on top of a hard wooden desk. My body feels heavy. It's pretty normal for me to zonk off in the middle of some boring class or whatever, but what was I doing asleep here just now? This isn't a classroom I've ever been in before. What the heck is going on? und die Instructions, die wir, glaube ich, überspringen werden. So. Ja, ich finde das auch sehr interessant, wie hier wirklich alles wie so Pappvorsteller gestaltet ist. Also wie so ein Aufklappbüro, finde ich. Das finde ich faszinierend von der Grafik her. Ich finde, das ist eine nette Idee. So, da haben wir hier so einen Cursor. So eine Art, ja, Zielgewehr, sage ich mal. Ist jetzt der falsche Ausdruck. Es ist kein richtiges, ja, es erinnert mich zumindest an einem Visier, sagen wir es mal so. Und damit können wir halt verschiedene Sachen anvisieren und halt untersuchen. Zum Beispiel der Zettel hier. Ich glaube, der ist gerade am interessantesten. That's the desk I fell asleep on. I can still see it lying. Or drawl, I must have left there. I'll have to clean that up later. Hey, what's that on the desk? An orientation guide? It seems kind of cheap looking, pampered, and just something handwritten on it. The next semester is about to start. Starting today, the school will be your entire world. What the hell? Is this someone's idea of a joke? So können wir uns halt schön durchklicken. Zum Beispiel diese Uhr. Jeez, I can't believe it's already 8 o'clock. It was just after 7 when I first got here. Has it really been almost an hour since then? Auch sehr interessant, hier werden wir alle gefilmt in dem Klassenraum. Das ist irgendwie so ein bisschen Verletzung der Privatsphäre. Ich glaube, wenn ich auf meiner Schule immer gefilmt werden würde im Klassenraum, das wäre irgendwie unangenehm. Is that a surveillance camera? It's a dangerous world we live in. I guess they have these to keep weirdos from just wandering in. So, wir können natürlich auch ein bisschen weiter im Raum umsehen. What the heck? In any normal classroom, that's where a window should be. But it looks like some kind of metal plate has been blown over it. And if I were to knock on it. Yep, definitely metal. Tick 2, very solid. Wait, that's not what matters here. More importantly, why are there these metal plates over the windows? Okay, let's see. So what might have happened is, I got myself so wound up, I passed out in the main hall, and then someone caught me here. Is that true? It must be in... This is a classroom inside Hope's Peak. But then, if that's true, that just raises more questions. This is all really strange. I mean, those metal plates covering the windows, it's like it's a prison or something. No wonder if this makes any sense. I should probably head back to the main hall. It's already past the meeting time. There might be other students there now. Yeah, you can leave the classroom, yay. So eine Art Shortcut, wir können allerdings noch das hier untersuchen. There's a TV. The school is founded by the national government, so I guess it's not that weird to have a TV here. Something feels off, I wonder what it is. Und ja, ich würde mal sagen, wir machen dann im nächsten Part weiter, wo wir dann den Klassenraum verlassen werden. Ja, ich hoffe, es hat euch gefallen und wir sehen uns im nächsten Part von Let's Show Danganronpa Trigger Bierwerk.